Now, after winning Pop Stars The Rivals at the end of last year, Girls Aloud have had three top three singles. Will this be the fourth? Ladies and gentlemen, from Girls Aloud, Cheryl Tweedy and Kimberly Walsh. Welcome. I was going to bring you on to Eye of the Tiger. I thought, no. Now, that was your new single, which comes out
Today,
yeah. And it's called Jump.
It is.
And it's in the movie Love Actually.
It yes. is, yeah.
So, you'd won Pop Stars The Rivals, and there was a boy band as well called, what was they called? Yeah, One True Voice. Yeah. And everyone thought they were going to be number one, and basically, you whopped them.
Yeah, we did.
And now they're gone. I'll bet you was chuffed when that happened.
We were really chuffed when we beat them, we were.
No, but when you heard that they'd disbanded, didn't you go, yes,
no,
losers?
To be fair,
no,
we felt sorry for them.
I mean,
they went through the same process as us. It was just unfortunate that they had a crap status. Yeah.
So it's all going brilliantly. You must have been thinking, what could possibly go wrong? Then... Now, there's some things I have to ask you, because I know you're looking nervous, Cheryl, but when you come on, everyone thinking, oh, it's that Cheryl Tweedy that hit that woman in the bog. Because you had a fight with a toilet attendant, yeah?
Yeah.
I don't really get the whole... Forget that toilet, that specific toilet attendant, but the whole toilet attendant... What is that about?
Well, in the clubs, like, today, nice clubs in the toilets, they, like, lay out perfume and sweets and things like that you can...
Sweets?
Yeah.
I wouldn't eat a sweet in a toilet if it was sold in a lead container. Now, this was a lady called Sophie Amagbokpa, and she worked in there, and you and her had a fight. Is that true?
Yeah.
Right. You're all right.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yeah, you must have known. I haven't just broken that.
No.
How pissed were you? What trail? How drunk, out of 20, Cheryl, how drunk were you?
Probably
12. Right, yeah. So you were sort of, but not being sick.
I was merry, I was enjoying myself, I was drunk, yeah.
Right. And the argument, we don't want to go into too many details about it, because I know there is another case coming up, but the argument basically was that you had too many lollipops, was that right?
Yeah.
Well, that's worth fighting for, isn't it? So you, what happened? Can you tell us what happened, kind of, briefly, with that?
Not really, but, you know, all this stuff come out...
You can't remember, let's face it.
No. All the details and everything were discussed in court, and there's another civil court case coming up, so I can't really... As much as I'd love to sit and yabber on all night about what went on and tell you the details, I can't.
Right.
Unfortunately.
But basically, you and her ended up...
There was a scrap in the toilet, yes.
Yeah. Now, you actually spent the night in Nick, is that right?
Yeah, I did, yeah.
That must have been a bit of a... Shocker. How was that?
It was scary. I mean, I've never been arrested before or anything like that, and it was cold. It smelled funny. It was just awful experience, really.
That's in the cell, you mean?
Yeah.
So did you sleep, or did you just...?
I just kind of twiddled my thumbs, rung the bell about 25 times.
They must have loved you. Yeah. What were you, room service were you after? Will you bring them lollipops? Because you were with Nicola, weren't you? Who's,
yeah.
Is that right? It was the ginger, is that right?
Yes. Yep.
There was always going to be trouble. So how did you find out?
So then Nicola came back and kind of come to mine and Nadine's room, and we were actually both still up together, and she was just kind of like, oh no, Cheryl's in a cell, blah, 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 and we were like, oh, no way. Kind of, obviously, we couldn't really get our heads around it at first. Mm. And then we went downstairs and obviously the police were there sort of taking Nicola's statement and stuff, and then that's when everything kind of came out then, what happened.
There must have been part of you that thought that stupid cow has ruined our big chance for fame. Maybe no, you don't think it now, but at the time...
At the time, don't get me wrong, I think it scared us all. We were like, oh, my God, this is, you know, this is really bad. And obviously, having only just, like you say, kind of got a record deal and just released our first single, everything did seem to be going so well. It was, you know, it was weird, but we never kind of felt bad towards Cheryl. We hadn't even spoken to you at that point, had we? And sort of we believed Nicola's, you know, side of the story.
No, because I was only allowed one phone call and I rang me, ma'am.
Exactly. So it was nice to actually see her and discuss it, and then we just kind of supported each other from there.
But to be fair though, Cheryl, you wouldn't blame them, would you, if they'd thought, no, oh God, no. If this, for example, part of the accusation, which I know you were found not guilty of, was that you'd made racist remarks to this woman. And then it becomes different, doesn't it? It's not just two people.
Yeah.
And if you'd been...